109, the old flying machine company, close by. Brian Smith, and up there, the Hurricane, fighting for that. Of the fighting collection. That Hurricane, 6 years in the rebuild. Built in Canada. To get this aircraft into its present state. Why is it the colours? Hurricane entered the war.
One of the rarest Hurricanes is here as well, ladies and gentlemen. Not up in the air, not yet, but later on this year, Duxford hopes to have flying the only airworthy example of the Sea Hurricane. Small building behind hangar number 4, you're able to see the reconstruction of the Shuttleworth Sea Hurricane, a naval development of this famous fighter, complete with eight. After a long period of restoration, the aircraft belonging to the Shuttleworth Trust should be in the air later this year, and we hope to have it for you for next year's fighter meet. So another new aircraft in the lineup next year, Jerry. How do they keep doing it?
A nucleus of 4 of these people, together with volunteers, rebuilt that aeroplane. And it's an astonishing testament to the skill of both these volunteers and the small number of full-time got flying now.
We have just taken off the 2 B-25s and the B-17 of Sally B. The P-47. They're all your prize, Duxford, Jerry. They're all your prize.
Bombers, the heavy B-17,
coming in here.
Yep.
The B-17, Jerry.
A flying memorial to the 79,000. Thank you. bombing aeroplanes official. very strong aeroplane made of man-made material. He goes by Toyota. But these very typical of aeroplanes in the 70s. All halfway through a very lousy, slow roll there, being chased by Mark, who's keeping his aeroplane the right way up. Paul Bonham obviously deciding that his view of the airfield from the inverter of formation flying there, almost. Mark is sliding just underneath him. And the two yaks in competition. That wing, yeah, that wing, almost symmetrical. So it meant that you've got as much control authority flying inverted as you have flying the right way up. Paul Bonham has decided that he's going to spend the rest of the display upside down, hanging with his head out. Give him a wave as he goes by, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure he can see. Off this pass.
A truly remarkable test of stunts.
Well, I mean, you're pushing to hold the aeroplane inverted. You're pushing against gravity all the time. Still served with distinction in the Korean theatre. And today, we've got Alan Walker. He's a spotter for our fighter. He's looking for concentration. Here we are now, looking out at the movie scenario.
Crackerjack leader.
Well, he's cracker, he's on his own, so.
We're running it now, rocket five.
T33 going to get a horn now? So really, this very much typical.
One of the early jet aircraft, T33. To its best advantage, the early development, the straight wing, the straight tail plane, two big many air forces around the world. Four squadron have intruded. Example, originally seen over here in the all-black markings of Ormond Cape. And I notice in the VIP enclosure somebody looking at me with great affection. John Davis.
scurrying in there over the fence.
Famous carrier pilots and test pilots.
Track undercarriage than the Wildcat we saw earlier, which in character with many of the pre-war Grumman carrier fighters folded its undercarriage into the fuselage for stability for landing on that heaving flight deck.
Thank you.
right. Thank you.
whilst well, this is happening, let's bring the music down and just listen to this wonderful, wonderful sound. Fighter display 1993, and you may applaud. John Lamont, Mark, the section leader this afternoon of this whole Valvo. Two Furies. Yes. Overhead one more time before they break right.